The Olympic Games 2016 in Rio de Janeiro are only a few days away, and only the best table tennis players on earth will be able to fight for the gold in Rio. Time to take a closer look on which players already booked their tickets for Rio and how the qualification process works. In total, 70 men and 70 women participate in the singles events. 40 out of those spots are secured through the continental quota places divided into 11 spots for Asia, 11 for Europe, 6 for Africa, 6 for Latin America, 3 for North America, and 3 for Oceania. Only 2 players per national association are allowed to compete in the singles event, with one additional player going if a national association qualifies a team. Every continental qualification tournament has a different playing system. Let's start with the Asian Olympic Qualification Tournament held in Hong Kong. The tournament consisted of 2 stages. As for Stage 1, 5 quota places per gender were battled out by regional competition: East Asia, West Asia, Southeast Asia, Middle East Asia, and South Asia. Players from the 5 respective regions of Asia competed among themselves to qualify 1 quota place each. The East Asian group was filled with the top stars of China, Chinese Taipei, Japan, Korea Republic, Korea DPR, and Hong Kong. On the women's side, we saw top seed Liu Shuwen struggling in her first match against Hong Kong's Du Hoi Kem by losing the match 4-2. On the same day, Japan's Ai Fukuhara surprisingly lost her match against much lower-ranked Li Ho Ching from Hong Kong. And in the quarterfinals, we saw another top favorite struggling. World champion Ding Ning suffered a bitter 4-2 defeat against Japan's youngster 15-year-old Mima Ito. In the end, it was China's Li Xiaoxia taking the first spot for Rio and giving herself a chance to defend her title in Brazil. In the men's competition, the biggest upset came by Chinese Taipei's Zhuang Zhiyuan, who eliminated Xu Xin in the quarterfinal. Ma Long of China stood victorious and booked his place in the first stage by beating teammate Fan Zhendong.
And there it is from down below the table, the swiping chop comes back.
With 5 places for the men's and women's events taken, the remaining spots were decided in the second stage. All players who didn't manage to secure their spot for Rio could compete in 4 different groups based on their current world ranking. However, only 2 players per nation were allowed to compete. In case one association already had 1 player qualified, only 1 player could participate. In a direct knockout format, the 4 group winners directly qualified while the losing finalists of Group A and B, as well as C and D, fought against each other for the final tickets. This makes 11 players from Asia qualified for the Olympic Games. The European qualification tournament was held in Halmstad, Sweden, as Dmitry Ovcharov and Li Jiao already earned a guaranteed spot at the Olympics due to their victories at the European Games last year. Only 10 spots were given away in Sweden. On the first day of action, players seeded number 17 and lower fought in the qualification groups for 48 spots in the knockout stage. Together with the top 16 seeds, they were divided into 8 knockout groups, with the respective winners directly qualifying for Rio. Panagiotis Giannis caused the biggest upset by beating world rank number 8 Vladimir Samsonov to secure his place in Rio. Other stars such as Timo Boll, Marcos Freitas, and Han Ying also secured their tickets to Rio. With 8 places taken, the players fought for the last 2 spots in the second stage. The remaining 56 players of Stage 1 were drawn into 2 groups, the red and the blue group. Only the 2 winners of these knockout groups qualified for the Olympics. Let's have a closer look at the African qualifiers. 4 out of the 6 available spots were given away to the semi-finalists of the African Games held last year: Omar Asar, Quadri Aruna, Khaled Asar, and Wang Jianan for the men's, and Dina Meshref, Nadine El-Dawlatli, Olufunke Oshonaike, and Han Xing took those spots. Already having 2 Egyptians in both singles competitions, Egypt was not allowed to participate in the qualification tournament held in Khartoum, Sudan. As for Nigeria and Congo Brazzaville, only 1 player was allowed to compete. In the men's competition, the first stage saw a round robin in 6 different groups. The winners and the runners-up, as well as the best third-ranked players, made it into the second stage. A knockout system starting from the round of the last 16. Next to Saka Suraju, Segun Toriola also qualified for the Olympics. This will be the 7th Olympic Games for the Nigerian, writing history for Africa, as he is the first African athlete to achieve this feat. In the first stage of the women's competition, the players were divided into four groups with the winners and runners-up progressing into the next stage, a knockout system starting from the quarterfinals. Saidani Safa and Edem Ofiong booked their respective tickets to Brazil. The Latin American qualification tournament held in Santiago de Chile gave away 5 spots for the men and 6 spots for the women, as Hugo Calderano from Brazil already qualified by winning the Pan American Games last year. In 3 stages, the last spots were determined. Every stage saw a red and blue draw for both genders, a knockout system where the winner directly qualified for the Olympic Games. Puerto Rico's Adriana Diaz clinched a spot for Rio at only 15 years of age, writing history for Puerto Rico as she is the first table tennis player from her country to compete at the Olympic Games. It didn't take long for the second Puerto Rican athlete to qualify, as Brian Afandor also booked his place for Rio, along with some other emotional qualifiers. The North American qualification tournament held in Canada gave away 2 spots for the women and 3 spots for the men, as USA's Wu Yue already qualified for the Olympic Games by winning the Pan American Games last year. Same as for the Latin American qualification tournament, every stage was a knockout system with the winner directly qualifying for the Olympics. 15-year-old American Kunuk Ja was able to win the third stage and wrote history by becoming the youngest ever male table tennis Olympian.
And there it is, ladies and gentlemen. We have crowned another Olympic athlete in this, the final match of the North American qualifier for Rio in table tennis.
For Oceania, the qualification system was a little bit different. The 6 men and 5 women who achieved the best results in the Oceania Championships the days before the qualification tournament were allowed to fight for the 3 spots. In the first stage, the 2 top seeds play for the first spot. The loser then has to play another match against the winner of number 3 and number 4 seeds. This loser then plays the last match for the last spot. With Melissa Tapper winning the second stage, she wrote history as she became the first ever Australian to qualify for both Olympics and Paralympics and the 13th athlete ever to achieve this remarkable feat.
Yes, she can! Well done, Melissa Tapper! And look at that smile. She has done it. The first Australian athlete to make the Paralympic and the Olympic Games.
With 40 spots taken, 22 of the remaining 24 spots were decided by the world ranking list in May 2016. On that list, the already qualified players, as well as players from a nation where 2 other players already qualified for the Olympics, were deleted. The top 22 players of that list then get the invitation for Rio. The 23rd spot of the remaining ones is taken by a host player, but as 2 Brazilians already qualified through the qualification tournaments, this spot was given to the 23rd player on the Olympic ranking list. The last spot is reserved for the tripartite commission invitation place. The tripartite spot goes to the highest world-ranked player from a country that had less than 8 athletes in individual sports or disciplines at the last 2 editions of the Olympic Games. This year, Syria's Heba Aleji and Paraguay's Marcelo Aguiare got their Olympic ticket. This is the list of the 64 qualified players through the ITTF qualification system, However, all the qualified players needed to get confirmed by their National Olympic Associations, and not every player was approved. Especially the decision of the Chinese team was highly expected and saw significant changes. On the men's side, world number 2 Fan Zhendong misses out on the Olympic Games as he got replaced by Zhang Jike. And on the women's side, world number 1 Liu Shiwen got replaced by Ding Ning in the singles competition. In addition to these players, the unused quota places of the team's event will be added to the ITTF Olympic singles ranking list for the singles qualification. And there we have our 70 athletes for both men's and women's competition. However, not only the singles competition will be played, the second part of the Olympic table tennis tournament will be the teams competition. The first stage of the qualification process are the 6 continental places. The best team of each continent who has 2 players qualified for the singles event gets the continental place. The remaining 9 team places are given away based on the Olympic team ranking list, with the priority for teams who already have qualified 2 athletes for the singles event. The last place is taken by the host country. As in this case, Brazil already got the continental spot for both men's and women's teams. 10 teams of the Olympic teams ranking can participate. All qualified teams bring additional players to make up a team of 3. From the 6th till the 17th of August, the Olympic champions will be crowned. Make sure to tune in.